Hey guys, welcome back. Carter with Bits Be Trippin' back in the studio. And this is a follow-up to yesterday's video that you guys saw when I was talking to the power and configuration for GPUs and or mining rigs when you're swapping between if that's ETC cash or if it's Ethereum's Fhash, and then moving over to something that's a little more power hungry, such as Ravencoin, and how to adjust some settings. So what this follow-up is today is on a 6-card mining rig. So this is 6 RX 580s that I'm gonna use, this 8 gigs GPUs. And what we're gonna show is the settings and the hash power that happens with that. So this rig was set up with a 1600 T2 power supply. It's way overkill for this rig. This rig was really set up for 7 GPUs. It could do 7 of the 5700s with that power supply. What we're doing here is to show you guys the difference in power setup here. We're gonna get into the config of this. You guys are gonna see what this thing's doing on Ethereum, in Ethereum Classic, actually, I think is what I have configured right now. And then we're gonna go over to Ravencoin and I'm gonna show you the settings and then show you that you can get your mining rig set up to use around the same power, not just the GPU single cards that I was talking to yesterday. And again, this is one quick example on one mining rig. We're gonna have a follow-up to even this series of videos with a whole bunch of other different GPUs. And I'll put that all as one video with some tables and outputs based on different GPU type that I think you guys will like, you know, as kind of a series of testing. Let's get into this and see what the power that this particular unit is using. If we kind of zoom in here on the power pull right now, this thing's mining ETC. We're getting about 180 mega hash on this rig, and we're using just under 900 watts of power. Now we can draw this down a little more, but what I'm doing is a very basic baseline and getting some expectations. Now, if we took the same exact configurations for this machine gets about 12.3 mega hash per GPU on Ravencoin. And when we look at that, we're using about 200 watts more power. So if this rig was really configured around like a 1,000-watt power supply because you were only using about 800 watts, you would obviously see your issue here. And also, if you had a 1,200-watt power supply, you'd be up there around that almost 1,100 watts here. But most people don't calculate the fact that their riser, especially if you're using not 6 pins directly to the risers and you're using your SATA connectors, this is where you're going to run into issue. This is where people are burning up their power supplies and or they're burning up their SATA connection. The main difference in that, where that power is coming from between Ethereum and Ravencoin, is it's going to pull a lot harder on the riser power. What does the risers pull in this particular situation? And what you'll see is the majority of that difference is coming from the risers. So if you're using a SATA based connector for your GPUs and you've went from Fhash to Ravencoin, there's a much more heavier load on that riser than there typically was, because that's where the delta and the power is coming from. And when we're looking at 200 watts here difference spread across the 6 cards of that, you're gonna take a riser from using about 45 watts, which is pretty high, up to around 65 watts when you're running Ravencoin on that riser. And the riser is really rated around 50 watts. I mean, they have a max TDP of around 75, but you really don't wanna pull more than around 50 watts to the riser. So if you're powering it off a SATA connector, especially if it's 2 SATA connectors in there, that's where you're gonna have your major issue. So you wanna make sure that if you're in that scenario, that you step these down, and we're gonna set these settings up to take that in consideration and drop the power down on this by taking the core down just a hair, and then we're gonna take the millivolts down. All right, so now what we've done, and this is gonna be very surprising for people, we've taken this rig and essentially matched what we were getting with Fhash when it comes to power. However, we were able to get an increase on the base clocks. When we were going base clock, for what we were doing on Fhash over to Ravencoin, we were at about 12.3 mega hash on Ravencoin. And we were using about 1100 watts, and it was pushing the cards a little hotter and a little more load on the PSU. And what we've been able to do is I'm showing you guys from a rig standpoint what we can actually bring down. So we took the core clock down to 1000 megahertz, from 1120. And we kept the memory at 2100 because this is still a memory-based algorithm. It does have a DAG. And then we've taken the core voltage down to 860. So that 860 helps us drive some of that power back down. And what we can see here, since the core is not working as hot and breaching 75C, it's not doing any kind of temperature throttling. And what we're seeing here is around 13. We're getting almost a full mega hash each on each card. So close to 13.8 to 14 mega hash. This machine now is running close to 83 mega hash, where it was right around 77, 78 mega hash in total. You need to play around with your rigs. Don't be afraid to pull that core down some. Test out if your rig is stable on the millivolt side, especially if you're running 580s. You can drop that millivolt all the way down to 860. Try 840, see if it is. These cards get a little flaky at 840, but this is the kind of stuff that I'm recommending. This is that carryover from the video from yesterday, but at a rig standpoint, to show you guys this thing operating and running. Hopefully this is a good one for you guys. You guys can actually see a rig and see how you can pull that power back down and keep the power on Ravencoin and still get pretty decent rates of return when it comes to the proof of work on Kapow, and not be killing your GPUs and using a lot more power. So if you guys like this kind of content, like, subscribe, share with your friends that are getting into mining, that are new. Hopefully this content is geared for those folks, and hopefully some of you veterans out there are also picking up a few other tips and tricks there. So I'll catch you guys on the next one.